Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Medical Simple by Hardik Shah. Today we'll have a discussion on male reproductive system. Male reproductive system, it majorly comprises of four different organs. First, testis, second, accessory ducts, third, external genitals, and the fourth is glands. Let us go through one by one. The first we'll discuss the testis. Testis as such, it is outside the abdominal cavity and it is well within the pouch. As we discussed in a previous slide, the testis are present in pairs. There are two testis present in male. These testis are present within a pouch. The pouch is known as a scrotum. What is the function of scrotum? The scrotum is mainly required to maintain the low temperature of a testis, nearly about 2 to 2.5 degrees centigrade lower than the normal body temperature. Why a male require a lower temperature than a body for spermatogenesis, that is for the sperm formation. Let us look at the anatomy, structural part of a testis. Testis are the oval shaped organ and it is very densely covered, having a length of nearly about 4 to 5 cm, and at the same time the width of a testis is 2 to 3 cm. As such, the testis are having a small compartments. These small compartments are known as testicular lobules. Nearly about 250 compartments or 250 testicular lobules are present in each testis. Within every compartment, within every lobule, you will find a highly coiled structure. This highly coiled structure are named seminiferous tubules. 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules are present in each testicular lobules or testicular lobes. If we will focus on a seminiferous tubules, it looks like this, where you will find a seminiferous tubules are mainly having a two types of cells. One is Sertoli cells, another is a germ cells. What are the functions of the germ cells and the Sertoli cells? Germ cells are majorly responsible for the formation of a sperm through a meiotic division. At the same time, what is the function of a Sertoli cells? Sertoli cells are responsible for providing a nutrition to the germ cells. What are the interstitial spaces? If you will see the structure of a seminiferous tubules, outside the seminiferous tubules, the region outside the seminiferous tubule known as interstitial spaces. This is interstitial spaces. Again, if you'll see the interstitial spaces, is majorly contain a specialized cells known as a leading cells. What is the function of a leading cells? Leading cells are mainly responsible for production of a hormone known as androgens. Androgens are considered as male sexual hormones. This was about the testis. Come to the second part, and that is accessory ducts. The male accessory ducts majorly contains a four different structure. Retrotestis. This is retrotestis. Second, vas efferentia. The third is epididymis. And the fourth is a vas deferens. What is the function of the accessory ducts? As we know, that seminiferous tubules, these are the seminiferous tubules, produces the sperms. These sperms travel from a seminiferous tubules to the retrotestis. From the retrotestis, it reaches to the vas efferentia. From a vas efferentia, it reaches to the epididymis, and last, it reaches to the vas deferens. Once it reaches to the vas deferens, so now the sperms are here into the vas deferens. Vas deferens reaches to the height of a abdomen, and then it simply bends on the height of a urinary bladder. Once it reaches to the urinary bladder, now you can see another organ, that is seminal vesicle. So a duct from a seminal vesicle mixes with the vas deferens, and this mixed duct directly opens up into the urethra. So this is how the sperms travel, stored and transported through the vas deferens into the seminal vesicle and then directly into the urethra, and from urethra it takes a exit out of the body. So urethra is the one which is originated from the urinary bladder, and it travels throughout the penis and opens up through the opening called urethral meatus. The third is external genitals. Only external genital which is present in the male reproductive system is a penis. As such, the penis is having a two function. It is made up of a special tissue which is required for the erection of the penis, and the second function of a penis is insemination. What is insemination? That's the process of introducing the sperms into the female reproductive system. As such, the penis, the enlarged end of a penis, the larger end of a penis that a male can see from outside is known as a gland penis, and it is covered by the loose fold of a skin named as a foreskin. The fourth and the last part of a male reproductive system is glands. Three major glands are present within the male reproductive system. One, seminal vesicle. Second, prostate. And the third is bulbourethral gland. What are the functions of this gland? In particular, seminal vesicles secretes the fluid which constitutes a plasma, seminal plasma, which is rich in fructose, calcium and certain enzymes. Along with the prostate, it also produces a fluid which is responsible for making a semen. The bulbourethral gland helps in the lubrication of penis, and at the same time, this semen is responsible for giving nourishment and a motility to the sperms which are coming from the seminal vesicles. This is about the male reproductive system. Thank you.